Want to Netflix and chill with this hunk of meat? No, you're probably a serial killer or something. Come on. Not everyone you meet online is a monster. Exclamation point. You're missing out on this. I can be there in 5 minutes. It's too easy. Welcome to Shadow Alley. On this channel, we talk about horror movies and silicone masks, and occasionally we do really cheesy, corny, dorky intros. So if you're into that sort of thing, feel free to subscribe and stick around. I kind of gave away what the mask was already, but who cares? I bought a mask from Composite Effects, and I'm going to unbox it, and we're going to check it out in great gory detail right now, and I'm actually really excited about this, so let's do it. You probably shouldn't use sharp things like this to open up a silicone mask box, because if it's right there on top, you might accidentally cut it and that would really suck. But I like to throw caution to the wind, you know, YOLO style.
Okay.
All right. So I'm gonna put this on the floor so that the packing peanuts don't get everywhere. Oh, geez. Oh my God. Okay. Oh, it's so bad. Oh, it's so bad. Oh, it's so bad. It's everywhere. We're okay. Haha, the newest mask in my creepy collection. Oh, man. All right, so if you know anything about me or this channel, you know I'm obsessed with 80s horror. So as soon as you see this, I'm gonna give you 3 seconds to say out loud what you think this reminds me of. What cheesy 80s movie? Why did I buy this? It reminds me of the movie Chud, you got it. Cannibalistic humanoid underground dwellers. Chud from 1984, a classic creature feature that I loved growing up. I saw this mask, it was in stock at Composite Effects. It's called the Dweller. So I'm assuming that it's at least inspired by the cannibalistic humanoid underground dwellers from the Chud movie. I would assume that that's where they got the idea of this. It's kind of an homage, and I had to have it. I had to have it in my collection, and I can't wait to do some really funny, cheesy things with it, like that stupid intro you watched. But it was $650, and Composite Effects, I think, ups the price of their mask just a tiny bit so that they can include a head form with it. So I know a lot of people ask me where I get the head forms. Composite Effects is a really great place to get them, and if you buy a mask from Composite Effects, it might be a few dollars more than you would get it somewhere else, but it also includes the head form, which is amazing. I love that. All right, so the mask itself. I mean, what can you say? If you are into kind of creature features and cheesy horror creatures, then this thing is perfect. It's amazing. One really cool thing about this, if you see right here, there are two little LED lights. And guess what you do with those? You put them in the eyes and you can make the eyes glow different colors. Just like from the movie Chud, actually, the eyes were glowing.
Hi, how are you?
So that is one really cool thing that adds a ton of production value to a mask like this, that you could completely shut off all the lights and just see the eyes glowing from under the bed or glowing from the closet or glowing from under the ground. I'm really excited to kind of play with that and see what types of colors we can get. I think it's amazing. I think it's cool. It is a little bit on the corny side, but in the best way possible. It just reminds me of those cheesy 80s horror movies. And the quality is great. I have a few of their masks already, so I knew what to expect. I knew that they are a quality company that make quality masks, and I am pumped. So the eyes are silicone, not acrylic, and the teeth on this one are silicone as well. So you'll have to be really careful if you do any close-ups where this thing is chomping its teeth together. You might see its teeth bend. So be very careful of that if you're gonna shoot something like this with silicone teeth, because those teeth may actually bend. So make sure that they're in the shadow, or you're just very careful with it. But we should be able to shoot around that. The paint job's awesome. It looks really cool. Let me try to figure out how to get the lights in the eyeballs so we can play with that and we can shoot it, and we will look at a movement video of this thing in really bright lighting, and then we will look at it again in a little bit more movie appropriate lighting like we always do. So let's go do that now. Yeah, look how cool this thing is. Again, it's that perfect combination of kind of cheesy, corny 80s monster for me. I love it. And obviously, if you're gonna shoot it this bright, you may be able to look inside of the mouth. If you open up the creature's mouth big enough, you may be able to see your own mouth inside of there, so be careful of that. But you probably shouldn't be shooting this in this much light anyway. I just wanted to show you what the mask looks like, and it looks really, really cool. You're actually looking through two tiny little eye holes on the insides in the tear ducts of the creature's eye, and it's really not that bad, actually. It's really comfortable to wear, and I can see pretty well through it, and you, even with this bright lighting, can't really see in to see the actual actor's eyes or the person wearing the mask's eyes. So that's awesome. But I think it looks really, really awesome. Now let's look at it with a little bit more movie appropriate lighting. So much better, right? It looks a lot creepier and a lot more like a monster, a dweller, a creature. And now obviously, since there's no bright light right in the face, you can't really see inside of the creature's mouth to see the actor's mouth, which is a great thing. That's obviously what you want. So again, guys, if you light these things correctly and work with what you have, you can make them, in my opinion, look really realistic and really amazing. And this one, like I said, is awesome and I love it. I can't wait to do some fun stuff with it. But this thing has one more cool trick up its sleeve. One of the biggest selling points of this mask is that it comes with little spaces inside of this eye that you can put LED lights to create glowing eyes. Now you get to choose what color glowing eyes you want when you order this from CFX. I didn't do that because I forgot, so they sent me the red ones and I think they look awesome. I might try to get some other colors to see what those look like as well, but how cool is that? You can actually light up the eyes on this thing, making it look way creepier and a lot more similar to the Chud movie. Awesome, right? I don't know why I waited so long to get this. I eyeballed this a few times on CFX's website, but I noticed that it was in stock, and I love when masks are in stock. You don't have to wait the, you know, 4 to 6 to even 8 weeks for them to produce the mask. It usually ships within a few days and comes right to your house, and that's what happened with this one. So CFX or Composite Effects, Dweller, $650, and it comes with the head form, and it comes with your choice of little battery powered LEDs that you can slip inside the eye. On the inside, there's just a single slit. You just put the LED inside of there and it lights up and it creates this awesome Chud like dweller creature. And I'm super happy to have this in my collection, and I'm definitely gonna do some cool stuff with it, hopefully in the near future. So, as always, please do all of those things you're supposed to do to help a channel grow, like and comment and subscribe and share it with your friends. And I'll see you in the next one.
Hi, how are you?